to use absolute referencing in Excel. For instance, we have to apply some certain additional information to the data set that is given about the employees in this data sheet. We want to increase the salaries of our employees by 2.91%. So this is the initial salary, and we need to add these to their existing salaries so that they got a new salary increase by 2.9%. In order to do that, if we use the normal approach in Excel, which is this multiply by this, and then we hit enter, we have this. Okay, so this multiply by this plus this. Okay, so we have the original salary multiplied by the percentage, added to the original salary, we get the new salary. So the new salary will be 56,137.41. That will be the new salary. And then if we drag, okay, to some places, you discover that there are some things happening here. So over here, something happens. If you watch here, what happens here is this. Okay, let's start from here. This means it is taking the value of this and multiplying it with this to give us this response, this answer, which is incorrect. So, and then when you look at this, it takes the value of this, multiply with this, and then if you hit enter, it gives us this. So this is what happens here, and this is not actually what we are looking for. It is not correct, so we need to remove all this. It is wrong. So here, in order to get what we want, you can also do it one after the other. This multiply by this plus this, okay, plus this, and then you hit. So this is what we should get. So you discover that doing it one after the other till the end of this data set will be a little bit bulky. It will take us time. So to do it once and for all, we introduce absolute referencing. So from here, this one is our multiplier. That is the percentage here, is the multiplier. So we are going to freeze it, and freezing it, we call it absolute references. Absolute reference. So just highlight it and click F4. So once you click F4, you discover that there are two dollar signs that is added before J and before 1. So once you hit that, click enter, and then if we drag, we discover we have the right answer. So this is what we call absolute referencing in Excel. And once you populate from here, you discover everything will now fill to give us the exact values of what each of the employees will get as their new salaries. So that's what we call absolute referencing in Excel. Then the next we talk about is what we call mixed referencing. Now, mixed referencing is very, very important. For instance, we have different regions, and then these are different products, and then each region has a quantity and the percentage that is allotted to them. Furnitures, these are different furnitures, and then each of them for the East should be 25%, and Midwest 20, South 30, Mountain 10, and Pacific 15. So you need to multiply 900 for this, and then 900 for this by 20. This will be by 25 by this. So if we also go through the same process, this multiply by say this multiply by this, okay, and we hit enter. So this is what we have. And then if you drag this to this, you discover that there is an error here. So if you want to understand what is going on here, just double click on this. You see that this takes the value of this one and multiply with this, and this one takes the value of this one and multiply with this, and this takes the value of this and multiply with this, which is wrong. So it should be this multiply with this, this multiply with this, this multiply with this. So just like this, we have a false sign. This multiply, no, multiply with this, and we hit enter. So it should be 200. Okay, so that's what we should get. Likewise, this. Now you can imagine if we have a very huge data set, we are trying to find out the correct quantities that must be sent to different regions. So to do it in a more easy way, so what we do here is what we call a misreference. So here now you highlight your C4, which is this blue one, the percentage, and then click F4. So this is here at this particular region. You can see dollar sign before this dollar sign. Still hit F4 again. You see dollar sign is now in between, and then we hit enter. So it gave us this, which is correct. And then if you want to also apply it in this place like this, see we have here 45. So here you need to understand what happens here. So here now it means that this is multiplying this 25 225, which is not supposed to be. So this should be 20% multiplied by 900. So to correct the error there too, so we come back to this case. So here now this B5, we now highlight it and click F4 again. So 3 F4. So you see the dollar sign is now in front of B, and then you hit enter. So drag this like this, you see 180. So highlight this, you see this is getting value from here times this. Do you understand? And then hit escape. So this one we drag down, correct. This now we drag everything. So the answer is now correct. So this is what we call misreferencing. So if you double click this, you see 20% multiplied by this. If you double click this, you see 10% multiplied by 200. Okay. If you double click on this, you see 15% multiplied by 200 gave us this. So this is what we call missed reference in SL. So I know you can use this when working on different tables, so that it will enable you to do your work more easier and more faster.